Today I have a card trick. I'm going to show you this card trick. Here we go. Just a bunch of cards, and I need someone to pick a card. So let's randomly pick a card out of there.
There we go.
There's your card. I haven't seen it. You're memorizing it, and you can stick it back in the pile here.
Anywhere I want?
Anywhere you like.
Okay.
All right, and just to be extra careful that I didn't see anything, it's really mixed up in there. There's no way I could know it. I'm going to shuffle these cards, and then now I'm going to deal them out into three piles. And for show, I need you to remember this card so that you can mentally pass along that information to me and we can help that card rise to the top. Okay, so you point to which column you see your card.
I see it in this middle one.
This one here, okay, perfect. All right, so we're going to divide them up again. And I hope you're remembering your card, because otherwise this trick might not work. All right, and now where do you see it?
It's in this one here.
Okay, that makes me a little nervous, but that's all right. All right, one more time just to be safe. Okay, so think hard about this card, and where is it now?
It is in this one.
This one, uh-oh. All right, I think that's okay. All right. Okay, so point to four piles for me, please.
Let's go with these four here.
These four here, okay, great. And now how about two piles from these ones left?
These two on the end, the two on the end.
Okay, and one more?
The one closest to you.
This one?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh no, I'm feeling nervous. Okay, one of these cards, please.
Middle one.
Middle one. How did we do? Did we do it? Did I not make it?
You got it.
I got it. Oh, thank God. I was going to get a little nervous. Are we going to have to do this again? Okay, great.
There you go.
That was very good.
All right.
Right. I imagine the people in the audience are probably a little more excited that it came out right. Maybe I'm a little more relieved.
Right,
let's break it down. So the first thing we need to know is the name of this trick is actually the 21 card trick. So the one piece of information I kept from you is how many cards I have. So I have 21 cards in my hand. And so you can really start thinking about this in terms of modular arithmetic. So I'm thinking about numbers, and when I divide that number by some fixed number like 3, I can ask for which remainder does that number have. It can have remainder 0, so maybe it's like 6 divided by 3 has no remainder. 7 has remainder 1, so 7 divided by 3, I can get 3 times 2 is 6 plus 1, so I can get 1, and then I can also have 2, so like 8 divided by 3 has remainder 2. Okay, so I can think about dividing up my numbers, any integer, divided by 3 into these three groups, where remainder 0, remainder 1, remainder 2. Okay, so we picked a card. That was the first thing we did.
Should I do that?
Yes, please.
All right.
Whatever.
So what are we
going to
get
like
this time? All right. So here, this time, 2 of clubs.
Okay, so everybody knows, and it's okay because eventually I already was going to know that. But okay, 2 of clubs. So we stick it back in, and just for show, I mixed them up.
This is legitimate. This was a real shuffle.
Yeah, this is for sure. I'm not doing anything special here, just to add to the enjoyment of the randomness of it all.
Oh, I could have shuffled them.
You certainly. My dog could have shuffled them, I guess. So 2 of clubs, that's the one we were looking for. The second step was to divide them up into these columns.
So it could have been anywhere at this point.
The card can definitely be anywhere. But now I'm dividing them up into 3 columns. If you recall, we discussed modulo arithmetic, so we're thinking about dividing up 21 cards by 3. So one of those cards has to be in the column where you could think the remainder is 1, the remainder is 2, or the remainder is 0. And so we see our card here.
Here it is, okay.
Okay. So the first thing we want to do is make sure that this column has to be sandwiched between the 2 other columns. And the reason I'm going to do this is because this one has seven cards in it. I don't know which card, you know, supposedly I don't know which card it is, but I know now it's somewhere in position, so there's seven here. Once I put this one on top of these cards, it's got to be positions 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, or 14. So in positions 8 through 14 lies your card, and then I'm going to add the rest of these cards here, and so that helps me know for sure it's right in this section, 8 to 14. So when I separate them up again or divide them up into these three columns, here are the first seven. Those are the ones that I stacked on top of my group.
You know I'm not in there.
Right. Here comes 8. So maybe I'll kind of go like this so we can see 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. So there's that collection of cards where your card has to live. And then I just do the rest of them here. And what happened is I took 8 through 14, I divided it up by 3, and those numbers have to have remainder 1, 2, or 0. And so it spread them across my columns, and now the rows that they live in has shrunk. So you can see that whichever card we know that we need to find has to be in row, so this one goes in here just to make it clear, has to live in row 3, 4, or 5. Another way you can think about it is as soon as I do this, the same thing of sticking whichever column you say your card in, which is here, after 7 cards, that means it's in position 8, 9, 10, 11, and possibly 12, because this one had 3 rows involved. Okay, so now I'm looking at positions 10, 11, and 12 that might contain your card. So now I'm going to pick up this column where your card lives. I'm going to put it between the two columns of 7 cards. And now we're remembering positions 10, 11, and 12. That's where your card should live. Okay, so here are the first 7, 8, and 9. Here comes 10, 11, and 12. And then the rest of the cards. So I knew your card should be somewhere in positions 10, 11, 12. And once I've divided those cards up, I've spread them across the columns. And so now when you point to the column, I know exactly which card it is. It's this one. And now to make it more exciting, instead of just saying, oh, here's your card, what I'm going to do is, again, take a pile of 7. I'm going to stick it in front of the pile that contains your card and then the other 7 afterwards. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, here's your card. It will always be in position 11. So all I need to do in this second, the last part of the trick is to count. So there's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There's your card. So as long as I've counted and I remember where the 11th card goes, now I can finish out my trick and make sure that I remove all the groups, remove all the cards that are not the 11th card, and at the very end, you'll be amazed.
You told me to pick groups.
That's
what,
right.
What were you doing there at the end?
I was making sure that whichever group you picked or didn't pick, it never removed the card that I wanted you to find. So if you said, I said pick 4 groups, and so you pick 4, maybe you pick these 4, I take them away.
You don't tell me before if you're going to keep or get rid of what I choose.
Not at all, because you're picking it.
So you told me that you first saw this trick as a result of learning it, like, with your children.
That's right.
Did you look at it and straight away think, mathematics? Or did you, like, how long did it take till you started thinking, this is mathematical?
No, I'd say immediately. I mean, it didn't help that the person who showed me the trick is also a mathematician, and we were with a group of mathematicians, so it's already embedded in my brain that there's math involved. But I know that there are 21 cards. I see 3 piles, and there are 7 cards in every pile, and you're doing it 3 times. I knew immediately math was involved.
Your youngster who does it, does she appreciate the mathematics, or has she just memorized, I have to know, you know, this is, she's just learned the routine?
She loves the response, yeah. She knows there's math, but she's much more excited to get the people to shout, oh my goodness, when she pulls their card out.
She's just running the algorithm.
Oh, for sure. She's a star. She's a superstar. She wants to be on TV. That's her goal.
We should have got her to do this.
I think so. I almost kept one home today from school just in case.
I know what you're thinking. Gee, I could really do with some Numberphile playing cards. Well, if that's the case, check out the link in the video description.